So whenever you are with someone in a relationship, it could be your siblings, it could be your parents, it could be your life partner, you have to take care of what you say, how you say, and what is the volume of what you say to them. Sometimes you use a language of a kind where the other person gets more offended and your aim of actually resolving the conflict goes in vain. So you have to be very careful of how you voice your displeasure to the other person, how you choose your words, what are the kind of words, are you being specific about how you feel, are you being specific about what you want to bring into their knowledge or consideration. So this is where I feel statements come into practice. So whenever you want to resolve conflicts in a relationship where it involves your loved ones, kindly use I feel statements, and that we are going to learn in this video. So friends, my name is Gurpreet Singh, I'm a life coach, and let's start this video. So people usually think that I statements mean that you have to be very polite or you have to be a very calm or relaxed state of mind. No, it's not like that. I statements are meant to be clear. They are not meant to be either rude. They are not meant to be either very polite, but they are meant to communicate clearly what you actually want to communicate. So I feel statements are the first step you need to take in order to open up a channel to resolve your conflicts. It will not really resolve your conflict by just using the statement, but it will open up new possibilities where both of you can sit together and talk about your issue. Because most of the time, whenever we voice our opinion or we voice our displeasure or we confront the other person for something he or she has done, we do it in a certain way that it actually blocks the channel of communication. It actually stops the communication. It actually stops any kind of activity between both of you. And that is where people get more distant from each other. And now when you use I statements, the other person is not going to actually reply to you in your voice or your tone or your kind of straight attitude. He or she will take time to cope up with your change in statement. So you really have to be very patient when you start using I statements to actually get results. Some people try it for a day or two and they don't get any result, and then they are disheartened and then they stop using these kinds of statements and they get back to their very rude kind of confrontations, which actually even worsens their relationship with each other. So that is why if you really want to create a channel for communication when your partner or the person you want to communicate is not actually communicating with you or is not actually wanting to talk to you, I statements will really give you a platform where he or she will be able to understand what you really need to communicate. You also want to inform the other person of their behavior, because sometimes the other person is not actually aware of what he or she is doing. The other person might be consciously, unconsciously making some decisions or doing some actions and he or she is not aware. And that is why the person does not want to apologize to you, or the person does not feel sorry for his or her actions. So when you use I feel statements, the person will be able to know more about what about his behavior or her behavior is causing harm in the relationship. So you need to use I feel statements when the other person is not treating you in the right way, in the ethical way, the moral way, or the justified way in a particular relationship. So when in a certain relationship you feel very angry or defensive, that is where you need to use I feel statements in the most accurate manner. Even when the other person is very angry with you and does not want to listen to anything what you say, I feel statements can actually stop the person, make him or her introspect and get the entire picture about the situation so that he and she can actually stop and listen to you. Before you start using I feel statements, make sure that you listen to the other person. You have to be very patient and listen to the other person. You also have to use reflective communication. You have to repeat what the other person is saying in his or her own words, in your own words, so that the other person knows that you are listening to that person. Do not interrupt the other person in between. Let him or her speak fully. Make sure that your body language also conveys that you are listening to the other person. Only then when you use I feel statements, the other person will get the signal that you have understood what he or she wants to convey. You have listened fully and then you are reacting in a I feel statement manner. Whenever you use I feel statements, you have to use I, that you are feeling in a certain way, not the other person is doing something or the other person is not responsible for what you are feeling. That gives the other person a chance to know how his or her actions or words are creating a negative impact on you. Always use I feel statements with respect to a particular behavior, not the person. If a certain person is behaving in a certain way, always point out that I feel in a certain manner when you behave in a certain manner, or when you say this, or when you say this, I feel in a certain way. So you have to actually blame the behavior of the person and not the entire person, because that is just one or two behaviors of the person which you want to change. So if you want to give the other person some suggestions, it would be in the manner that it would be very nice, or it would be very great if you would do in such a way, or it would be highly appreciated if you do this in a particular manner, or it would be nice of you if you did this, or I would feel even more better if you did in a certain way. So you have to use such kind of communication when you actually put across what you really want from the other person. So as you see on the screen, it comes step by step. First is you will say I feel dash. Okay, second is when you do a particular thing, what the other person is doing. Third is because I think that it means this, because what is your interpretation of what the other person is doing. And then you would use you feel certain emotions, that is either it would be afraid, you feel afraid, you feel angry, you feel hurt, you feel jealous, you feel sad, you feel mad, you feel rejected, you feel dejected, you feel lonely, okay? Then second is when you do a particular thing, second is the specific action, the behavior of the person, or a certain request from the other person. The third is because I think it means you don't care, because I think it means you don't love me enough, because I think it means that you don't value me, because I think that it means you don't want me anymore. Because usually when you confront the other person, you usually use very specific words, and you are actually using absolute words. So you would now understand some basic examples of certain conflicts and how you can use I feel statements in order to overcome the conflicts and create a ground where both of you can communicate. Okay, number one is suppose when there is a lack of attention between both of you. Okay, so you statement would be, you don't care about me, you are inconsiderate, you never make time to call or text me. Okay, so this is a very absolute statement. You are actually directly blaming the other person for not giving you attention. So how would you use I feel statements? The I statement would be, when you don't pay me attention, okay, or call or text me, I feel disconnected and lonely, or I feel disconnected and lonely when you don't pay attention to me or call and text me. Okay, so this will take the responsibility part on the person who is actually doing something and make him or her realize what his actions or his words are actually making you feel. So he will take the responsibility on his or her own. Second is with respect to household work. Okay, so the you statement commonly used is, you don't help out enough, you just expect me to clean up after you. Okay, so if you want to change this into an I statement, it would be, when you don't help out, okay, with the household work, I feel overwhelmed and unappreciated. Okay, are you understanding how it has to be done? Okay, third is with respect to money matters. Okay, so whenever we have to confront the other person with respect to money matters, the you statement is, you spend money carelessly, okay, and don't watch the budget. Okay, this is actually blaming the other person. But when you use I statement, it's when you spend money on extra items or not so important things. Okay, it makes me feel nervous and stressed. Okay, or it makes me feel that we won't be able to meet our daily requirement, or maybe our monthly expenditure limit, or maybe our yearly budget. Okay, so here you don't have to sound like you are blaming the person, but you have to sound like you are more responsible than the other person, and you also want the other person to be responsible. Okay, with respect to work, okay, the you statement commonly used is, you care more about work, okay, than you do about your family. So you are actually now creating a divide. You are telling the person that he doesn't or she doesn't value the family, and he or she values the work more than the family. So you are actually blaming him on his priority path. Okay, usually this happens with respect to when wives tell their husbands that you don't value me anymore, or you value your mother more than me. Okay, so I statement would be, when we don't get to spend a lot of time together as a family, okay, or as a couple, okay, I feel disheartened and unfulfilled. Okay, this would be a very good example to put it across. Next is with respect to intimacy or sex, okay? You statement which is usually used is, you never seem to want to have sex, okay? Anymore, you don't find me attractive. So this is actually blaming your partner, and it is also coming upon your self-esteem and confidence, because usually when you use a lot of these kinds of statements, when you directly blame the other person, indirectly you are blaming yourself for something which is happening or not happening, okay? So you don't have to actually mess up with your self-esteem or confidence. That is why you have to use I feel statements. When you don't initiate intimacy, physical intimacy with me, I feel unwanted and undesired. So this would be the right way to put it across. With respect to using the cell phone or mobile phone, usually a lot of conflicts happen because of mobile phones. The use statement commonly used, okay, it could be also used with your children, okay. You are always on your phone reading, texting, emailing, okay. You care more sometimes or sometimes else than what's right in front of you. Okay, you are telling the person that he or she is not responsible. Okay, now the I statement would be, when you keep your phone out at dinner, I feel unappreciated and unimportant. Okay, other would be, if when you use your phone at the time of studies, I feel that you are not very much serious about your exams. Okay, you could use this statement with your children. Okay, now the last part is about listening. Okay. When you are blaming or actually pointing out the other person is not listening to you. Okay, so the you statement commonly used by everyone is, you never hear me, you don't understand me. Okay, now this is actually blaming the person for being immature in some way or not having that knowledge to understand you. Okay, I statement would be, when you don't listen to me compassionately, I feel helpless and hopeless, I feel frustrated and alone. So okay, you have to convey your feelings, how you feel, and then the other person will try to take responsibility or try to clarify, did he or she mean that way? Because this will also give you assurance. Most of the time we assume that the other person is doing a certain thing because he or she feels in a certain way or has certain feelings about me or doesn't have any feelings about me. So because of this, we just lower down our confidence and self-esteem. And we go into, sometimes we also go into self-hate. So in order that you also get a realistic picture of you, okay, what you are and what are your attributes and what are your good and bad things, you have to be very clear, and to be able to get a clear picture from the other person, you have to give a clear picture to that person. That is where I feel communication will help you the most. So this will help you. Usually when I get clients and they are not on talking terms and they do not even want to come for counseling, or one person wants to come for counseling, so we tell that particular person to start using these statements. And when this happens, the issue because of which both are having the conflicts, it comes at the surface level, it comes at the discussion point, and then they agree to take a session. So friends, from today, start listening actively, start following reflection, start using I feel statements, and try to understand more of what your partner is actually trying to convey to you. And also let your partner understand that, what do you actually understand from their communication. So friends, this is it for the video. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, kindly comment, share, subscribe to the channel, and keep watching Life Coach.